My name is Anne Gunn. I wrote the Catalogue Raisonné of the Prints of Wilhelmina Barns-Graham. I'm going to be looking at a work from the 2000s. Barns-Graham made prints throughout her life, but the most consistent and largest body of work were the screen prints she made in the last years of her life, from 1998 through to just a few days before she died. These screen prints were made in collaboration with Carol Robertson of Graal Press. Carol had worked on making new materials and techniques for screen printing, and these allowed for much more nuanced and sophisticated mark making than had been previously possible with screen printing. And they allowed Barns-Graham to match the way that she painted. I've chosen to talk about the Earth series because it exemplifies several things to do with Barns-Graham's work. It shows how she liked to work in series, changing the image from one print to the next. It illustrates her incredible sensitivity to colour, and it also shows the way that she would sometimes use serendipitous glances, sideways looks at something to change the way a work came out in the end. This is my favourite of the five prints in the Earth series. This is Earth 3. And I love its warm, glowing colours and the layers and its strange central motif and its intriguing title. Barns-Graham usually gave titles to works after she had finished them. They were never literal, and she didn't like them to explain her work. She didn't want to tell people what they should think about her work, but she did give a clue as to how one might look at them. She said, "People only have to breathe deeply and look. If there is anything they enjoy, a shape or a colour, that's tremendous. People mustn't worry or be anxious about understanding it all. I can look at a page of beautiful Chinese calligraphy and not have a clue what it's about, but sense a worthwhile idea." So I love the warm, glowing, earthy tones of this picture. As I said, the layers you can see, but this incredibly strong central motif and the two black marks either side of it. It's like a meteor hurtling to Earth through fiery realms. And this motif appears in all five of the Earth series, but changed in various ways from one to the next. So in Earth 1, it's a very simple, flat print with just three colours. Earth 2 has a white background with an orange bar, which seems to be impeding the way of the meteor. Then this one with this lovely balance, the equilibrium between this rushing movement. But with Earth 4 and 5, there are more complex images in it, more marks appear, more colours. But there's also something else that's different about them, which you might not notice at first glance. In her diary on the 24th of July 2003, Barns-Graham wrote, "Carol had sent a print of white shape, a touch of yellow on terracotta, designed 2 years ago, and this one I disliked and suggested two white shapes should be greyed or blushed. She'd made a pastry yellow and a sweet pink. By chance, I saw it upside down, and it was a fresh idea, and the pale pink worked as a shape going out. What relief." In that quote from the diary, apart from the seeing the picture upside down, which is how it is now editioned, with the movement going up, she talked about the change in colour. And this is another factor in Barns-Graham's work, incredible accuracy and sensitivity to changes in colour. And this became a problem with this series, because the main colour in the Earth series is an iron oxide red. See here a sort of rust colour. And halfway through editioning the print, they ran out of pigment. So Carol Robertson ordered some more from the supplier in Germany. And when it came, it was slightly different colour. So they asked at the quarry why this was, and it turned out it came from a different seam. The old seam had run out. This was a new seam of iron oxide, slightly different in colour, and just wrong, and something that Barns-Graham noticed. So Carol had to actually mix pigments rather than using the pure pigment to finish the addition to get the colour right. And that sensitivity to changes in colour is very typical of Barns-Graham's work. And one might speculate that this change in colour or this knowledge of where the pigment had come from perhaps gave the idea for the title of Earth, realizing, which she probably knew already, that many of the materials for making art actually do come from the bowels of the earth.